In the Bucegi Mountains in central Romania, a cave has been claimed to be discovered, within which there are very tall stone tables and ancient technology. Is the place authentic and artificially constructed? And if so, who built it?
This would appear to be as if a carving has taken place. We have a flat roof and a flat floor. We have columns inside as if they would be suspending or holding the weight of the ceiling against the floor. This is a large place indeed, and we would find this would be indeed prior to that as to the region or area itself, surrounded by water, that is to say, the land now presently seen from the Polish northern sea to the mountains and the surrounding area were covered, and this would extend in and around this area as well. However, the building of this would be more like the carving of the same. This would be somewhat of a shelter or a food storage shelter, a shelter for a lot of, let us say, items as well as food. Here this would be the Atlantean storehouse when there would be the migration to the Pyrenees and the surrounding areas itself. These would be natural caches or places used first for storage, but also for meeting places, and then to some degree even centers of government or council meetings, you'll say. You would go to that would be the 10,500 year from the entering in of the Nazarene, and you would find these places rather active, you'll say, sporadically over time used and then abandoned and then used again. Also shelter from those animals that would be rather large that roam the earth itself, you'll say. This is more to a structure that was carved rather than that they would be formed arbitrary nature, you'll say.
In this structure, there's supposedly a console of some sort, and if one places their hand over it, it gives a readout of one's DNA down to the atomic level. Other consoles displayed videos like holograms. Do you see this as correct or just science fiction?
As we've indicated, those that would be previously inhabiting this place used it for different reasons or purposes, and as we have indicated, first for food storage, then for either items that would be used as you are delineating, then for acts of government or meeting places. And the people were quite large, this is correct. We don't see it as science fiction, but more as to the technology, which is even now using the heat from the hand to activate cell phones or other obstacles. This is now the precursor to what was used then, using the energy around the hand, that you would call the aura, for lack of a better term. This would be an indication of how to use that was somewhat recorded by Lamsang Rampa in his descriptions of the Atlantean chambers and machines. These are well recorded or mentioned in his writings. These were used indeed with the mind and the energy of the body, which would be somewhat of a battery energizing the controlling center or machinery, if you would see it in that regard. The body is not a battery, however, but it has an electrical charge it carries with every human body. And those in antiquity were in particular higher vibration and higher energy flows, and therefore were able to do this rather simply, as if anyone who uses a cell phone now would tap on the phone itself and cause things to happen. These types of equipment, machinery, if you will, or indicators were used in the same fashion. You had to know how to use them intuitively, telepathically, or mentally, else they would not work. But in the lower aspects or realms, yes, there could be provocation, as you have just stated, you'll say. Action.